having a good day.
Good. Great.
Coach Ellis, what we were talking with Coach Brahma about third down, you guys are holding teams under 30% conversion on third down. What is it about that group? You get some new bodies in there, first of all. What is it about that group defensively that is kind of gelled this year? And how important is it to have a few fresh bodies in there on those third downs?
I think the biggest thing is, you know, Coach Brom and Coach English approach the third down. Third down starts with winning first down and second down. Those are the tough downs. That's when you got your cleats in the ground and you got to get your nose dirty. Third downs are down where, hey, you can pin your ears back and have a little fun, but you got to win second and third down. As you know, the game of football is all about red zone and third down. So the more you limit opponents' opportunities, and the way you do that is get off the field on third down. I think our guys are taking great pride in that. We talk about consistency or just being focused, and those guys just doing their job, and hopefully we'll keep having success.
You've seen the most growth in this defense from the time that you guys got here till now, because obviously Coach talked about just making adjustments every week, and you know, how do you feel like the guys have just kind of responded to that?
I think the main factor is that college ball is different from pro ball. Pro ball, they have preseason games. I think they have three or four. In college ball, you know, once you get through fall camp, the foot hits the ball. And I think for those guys, just getting a good understanding of what we're trying to do defensively, and also as coaches, getting a chance to get a feel for our players. I think the guys have bought in. They're developing that brotherhood. And I think once you get into a game and they feel some success, it's just human nature that those guys want to gain more and more success. And we're just going to keep pushing the envelope and hopefully keep continuing to be, you know, do well on defense.
Coach, how have you gotten some of the guys to kind of stay in their lane, so to speak, like not do too much, just kind of do what they can do, not over pursue, but also try to be aggressive?
It's basically like, you know, fixing a puzzle. You know, everybody has a piece to the puzzle. And if one piece is out of the puzzle doesn't look right. And so we consistency and we harp on those guys just, hey, man, this defense is a fun defense to play in. Everybody can make some plays in this defense. But the most important thing is to make the plays you're supposed to make and just do your job. Coach English and Coach Hagan do an unbelievable job of showing the guys, making sure they have a clear understanding of what we're trying to do schematically and what the offense is trying to do to attack us. I think that's where Coach Brum comes into where we teaching the guys defense, but he's teaching us offense. And I think we have that balance. Hopefully we continue to have success.
When Griffin went down early in camp, he was a huge part of what they were able to do last year. When they got better, it was really when he started playing. So how big of a blow did you all think that was, and how have you been able to overcome it?
First of all, MJ is an outstanding young man. And before I get to MJ part of your question, just after the injury, man, he'd been one of the greatest leaders. I had a chance Saturday night on our game. We got a chance during the fourth quarter, and they played the Joker and the Thief. And I look up, you know, MJ is right there pumping the guys up. When you come off from a timeout or a sudden change or anything of that nature, MJ is there coaching the guy. We really call him Coach MJ. But to answer your question, once he's injured, you hate seeing a guy injured, especially a young man that put as much time and effort into his preparation that MJ does. But also, it allows guys to see the way MJ worked. And that's a different plan, DB. It's not about being all Hollywood. It's about coming to work every day. And the guys get a chance to see a visual of the time and the effort and the dedication you put in. And I really think when Cam, Mink, even Devin got a chance to see how hard MJ worked, they just bought in what he was doing. And I think that's the true brotherhood and the true leadership of that group.
Coach, Virginia Tech's been playing a lot better because of their quarterback and his ability to run. Jeff was talking about the challenge of facing their quarterback. When you have a quarterback that does present that type of a challenge, a physical guy that can go up against a defender, what kind of challenge is that for your group when you have a guy that might pull defenders from other spots?
You know, he's a really good quarterback. I think they won three of their last four games. He's a big, strong guy. He's a dual-threat quarterback. They can throw it. They can run it. They can make some ad-lib plays when things break down. He can convert on third down. So for us, it's It's about being fundamental and sound, staying in our gaps. And when you got a chance to make a play, I mean, you have to make a play. But it's going to come down to us chasing the football. That's what it's going to come down to. The one guy missing because he's such a good player, we're going to have other hats there to get him down. Because one guy's going to have a hard time getting him down. Like you said, he's a big, strong guy. He avoids a lot of tackles. He misses a lot of tackles. So we got to do a good job of chasing the football, pursuing the football, and getting hats there. So when one guy misses, we can attack with our leverage and get him on the ground.
Coach, it seems like Quincy was playing so well that teams have kind of been like, you know what, we're not even going to try. We're not even going to try. How do you kind of make sure he, you know, because they haven't tested him a ton recently. How do you make sure he stays into it, and how good has he played this season for you?
I think Quincy is doing well for us. There's some things we definitely need to improve on, but he just steady at it. He come to work every day. He practices with a relentless effort. The biggest thing with him is just, hey, stay in it. In the confines of the defense. If you got don't get a lot of action, a lot of guys may want to drift. His main focus, stay on course. Just continue to do your job, and when you got a chance to make a play, make a play. But again, like I said, it's a friendly defense for those guys. You'll get your opportunity to make plays, but just stay in the confines of this defense. And when the opportunity presents itself, just make the play.
Steve, Jeff's talked a lot about how the secondary's coverage and ability to hold for that extra second or two has helped the defensive line be able to generate pressure. I'm curious how much more confidence your guys have on the back end, knowing that your front gets that kind of penetration consistently. Does it help them a lot?
I think it does, especially when those guys got Ashton, they got Steven, they got Tell, they got those guys chasing the quarterback. Just know, hey, if I cover my guy for a half a second, those guys going to be there. I think it's a tribute to Coach Hagan, what he's doing up front, a tribute to Coach English with some different things he's designing so those guys can get home. Our job to make sure whatever call being called, be in the best position possible to help those guys, you know, create positive plays for us on defense.
Sort of a two-part question. When Coach Brohm contacted you about coming here, how quickly did you make that decision? And then once you got here, did you look at this group and think this was going to be a pretty good defense, this good a defense?
When you get a chance to look at Louisville from afar, it is a place that, man, if I ever got a chance to coach there, I love to coach there. So when I finally got a chance to speak with him and I got a chance to be offered a job, I said, I'm there yesterday. And it's just a place I always wanted to be if I ever had the opportunity to. This is a great town, great fan base, great players. Look at tradition of Louisville, you think of the offensive guys. But when you think back, look at Louisville tradition defensively, you think about a Ray Buchanan. You think about a Holloman that won the Jim Thorpe Award. You think about Jahir Alexander. That's a big-time corner in the National Football League. So this, even just this past year, Trey Clark, they were drafted by the Arizona Cardinals. So you got a chance to look at that. You say, hey, man, you know, guys have done really well here on defense, especially in the secondary. So it's always a challenge for you to try to uphold that standard and also that competitive nature in you that you want to play in the ACC, one of the top conferences in the country.
Steve, Storm has been forced into – he played some early, but with Jarvis in and out, he's been out there quite a bit. How do you feel like he has performed, since he's been out there?
You know, Storm is a veteran. You know, play a lot of ball in the ACC conference. So for him, it's just rolling guys in. His number was called the last couple of weeks. He'll stepped up. He did an unbelievable job, and I'm expecting him to keep having some success, even play better and better the more reps he get. He come to practice, he work, he studies, he prepares. He's been consistent. He's been a great leader for that room. Just an older guy with a businessman approach. And I'm definitely excited to have him part of this team.
When you have the success you guys have had through eight games, there's going to be talk nationally about your program. You're going to be in different polls and different things. How much does that help? As a guy who goes out recruiting, you were on the road a couple weeks ago, how much does it help the positive news in recruiting? How much can you use this?
I think it's tremendous, especially just the media access that we have in the state of Louisville. You go out to high school recruiting, everybody sees us on TV. Just the brand itself, even Lamar Jackson doing the things he's doing in National Football League. When you walk in a school, man, you know, that Cardinal, it represents something. Guys know exactly who you are. Doesn't matter what state you're in, they know that Cardinal. But for us, from a national stage of us getting the guys ready, Coach Brohm preached since I got here, just one game, man. It's a one-game season. And I think our players have definitely bought into that. My high school coach used to say, when you guys play, play for the man sitting in the top of that stadium that just had enough money to buy that ticket. And when he leave the game, make him say, man, that's a unit that plays like a brotherhood. They play with fire. They play with effort. That's a group I want to come watch play. And I think that was Coach Prom's biggest thing he's selling is, hey, man, it's a one-game season. Make sure the fans of Louisville, when they come to purchase a ticket, they can leave the game saying, I want to come back and watch that group play again. And that's something we try to do every Saturday.
Steve, I guess I was asking Jeff about this too, but, you know, to only give up 7 points in the first quarter through eight games, is it an energy thing? Is it just a discipline thing? I guess, what do you see from the guys pregame that has allowed them to be able to have that success early on?
Again, I go back to Coach Brom, just his attitude. It just is a one-game season. You know, there's no ups, there's no downs. Just try to stay steady at it. And the preparation those guys put into the game. I think our guys do an unbelievable job, especially during the week of preparing. Just the way practice is structured, give those guys just a bead on what's going on. And hopefully we continue to do that throughout this season. That's good. Thank y'all. You guys have a good day.